Welcome to this video where we're going to show you how to paint the flesh on the Great Gnashtoof ridden by the killer boss in the Warhammer Age of Sigmar Dominion box set. Now, to prepare my model for painting, I've already undercoated it here with Mechanicus Standard Grey Spray, as it's the ideal colour to use for all the colours I'm going to paint onto my Great Gnashtoof's flesh. The first base coat I'm going to apply is Demonette Hide, which I'm going to paint all over the flesh. So for this, grab your large base brush. Let's take some Demonette Hide from the pot here and apply it to my palette like so. I'm going to need quite a bit here as it's quite a large model. We're also going to take some water and thin it down just to make sure it goes on real smooth. Then onto my Great Gnashtoof. Here I'm painting this all over the flesh of the beast. And at this point, the chances are you'll probably hit other parts of the model as well. It's not a problem. That's why we're doing this first. This flesh part's going to be quite messy. So we'll get this out of the way and then you can paint the other parts of the model later on. Apply this all over the flesh like so. You may find in your second coat to get a nice solid colour. That's not a problem. Let the first one dry as always, and apply a second thin coat over the top. There we go, a nice solid base coat of Demonette Hide all over my Gnashtoof's body. It took a couple of coats to get a nice solid colour, but it's really worth spending the time to do that. Up next, let's put a wash all over. Now for this, I'm going to be using Caraber Crimson, but I don't want it to be too strong, so I'm going to be thinning it down quite a bit with Larmian Medium. Here's how. First of all, let's take some Caraber Crimson from the pot here and apply it to my palette like this. Then I'll wash my brush off to make sure there's absolutely no paint left on there at all. Then I'm going to take two big dollops of Larmian Medium here and apply it to the palette like so, and then mix them in like this. And what this is going to do, it gives a really thinned down Caraber Crimson. Then I'm going to apply this all over my Great Gnashtoof's body. A nice even coat like this, being quite liberal. Now you'll see straight away it falls into all the recesses. Just make sure you're getting all the deeper bits of the model, especially scarred runes on the back of the Gnashtoof's hind there. There we go, the Caraber Crimson has dried, giving this really cool subtle effect on the flesh. But let's bring out some more of the details now with a few dry brushes. First up, I'm going back to my Demonette Hide pot again and dry brushing that all over the skin. Then I'll use Warpfiend Grey to do the same, and finally Slaanesh Grey as well. For all of these, I'm using my medium dry brush. Let's start off with some Demonette Hide then, and take it from the pot here and apply it to a piece of tissue paper I've got ready. Now what I'm doing here is getting rid of almost all the paint onto this tissue paper like so. So just working that paint in like so, just having very little left on the brush. Then onto my Great Gnashtoof. Here I'm dry brushing it all over the skin like so. It'll be quite subtle to begin with, but you'll slowly start to see some of the details being picked up just like this. Then it's another dry brush, this time Warpfiend Grey, again being dry brushed lightly over the top like this, and you'll start to see some of those lighter details being picked out. And up next is another dry brush of Slaanesh Grey, this time again being just dry brushed lightly onto the hide. Now here I'm actually using the dry version of Slaanesh Grey to make it a little bit easier to dry brush with, but you could use the layer paint instead if you wanted. So there we go, with that dry brush complete, the purple areas of the flesh are done. Let's move on to painting the fleshy underbelly of our Great Gnashtoof next, and for this again we're going to be using a few dry brushes. Now I'm going to start off with a dry brush of Bugman's Glow onto those areas to really blend into the purple. Then I'll use Cadian Flesh Tone over the top, followed by Eldar Flesh at the end. First of all, it's Bugman's Glow, and for this to get a nice smooth transition, I'm going to be using my small dry brush. Let's take some Bugman's Glow from the pot here and apply it again to this piece of tissue paper we have ready. Now I'm getting rid of most of the paint onto the tissue paper here, as always. What I'm looking for here is a really light and subtle dry brush. I'm going to be building up the layers here, rather than having a harsh transition. Then on the Great Gnashtoof, here I'm applying this onto those areas, but using a circular motion like this to help blend it into the purple. Now you'll see it's going to be very subtle as I start off here, but as I build up the layers, that fleshy colour is going to start coming through. I'm painting this onto the inside of the legs, the underbelly under here, and of course the bottom of the neck as well. Have a really good look at the books that come with Dominion, and you'll be able to see where all the fleshy bits of your Great Gnashtoof are. Next up, it's another dry brush of Cadian Flesh Tone. This time I'm concentrating towards the middle of those fleshy areas, leaving the outside the Bugman's Glow colour. So just making sure it's getting lighter as we're going under the belly like so. Work your way around with this again. Just be nice and careful to make sure we don't hit those purple areas. And the last dry brush here is Eldar Flesh. This is being used here to add a few highlights to these areas, so just make sure you're dry brushing on the absolute insides and lightest parts of the fleshy bits. Eldar Flesh is of course a dry paint, so it's perfect for this job. If you haven't got Eldar flesh, you could always use Kislev flesh instead. There we go, that's the lighter fleshy part done. Now up last, let's have a look at how to paint the darker areas of hide and the hair on the Great Gnashtoof. Now for this, I'm going to create a glaze from Basilicanum Grey mixed with Lamia Medium. Now you might think, why am I using Lamia Medium here with a contrast paint? Well, that's so I can have a really nice smooth glaze and to make sure it dries nice and matte, which is exactly the effect I'm looking for on this particular model. Once I've done that all over the areas I want, I'll then get back to using Basilicanum Grey by itself to add some darker areas on the hide as well. First up, let's have a look at how to mix that Basilicanum Grey and Lamia Medium. And for this, I've got my medium shade brush. First of all, I'll take some Basilicanum Grey here and apply it to my palette like so. Then, as always here, I'm going to wash off my brush to make sure there's absolutely no paint left on there at all. Then, I'll take some Lamia Medium, and for this, I think maybe two brushfuls of Lamia Medium will be perfect. Then I'll mix that together with Basilicanum Grey to make a really thinned down glaze. That's absolutely perfect. Now onto the Gnashtoof. Here, I'm mixing this onto the areas I want to paint as the dark hide. So the darker hide on the hindquarters here, for example, I'll just work it down like this. And you'll see straight away it's going to be very subtle when it dries. I'm actually going to be applying a few layers here to make it a little bit darker and working the layers up towards the back like so as it gets a bit darker. It's going on nice and thin now, which is perfect. And don't forget to paint the bottom of the legs as well, as you want the same effect here going up from the feet. Okay, so I've added about three or four layers of the glaze we mixed before and built up the layers like this. And you can see the subtle transition between the purple hide and the black areas there. And finally, we're just going to finish off by taking some pure Basilicanum Grey here, just on the absolute top areas like this, just to give some strong colour there. I'm also going to be painting all the hairs all over the Gnashtoof body as well. So I'll be picking out those out, like these ones here, for example, and the ones on the underbelly too. So with that Basilicanum Grey done, the flesh of our Great Gnashtoof is complete. Well, I hope you've enjoyed that video. Happy painting.